Children, how are you all? Hope you all are fine. I am your grade 3 English teacher. Now see children, we have completed our block 2. I hope you all have completed your class of children. I gave only 2 question answers in block 2 children. What was block 2? Let me do fast recap. We have studied about adjectives, how adjectives describe a person. What are adjectives? Adjectives are nothing but they will describe a noun in detail. It tells us brief about noun. You know what is noun? Name, place, animal and thing is noun. What this adjective will do? This adjective will describe the noun children. Yes, this we have studied in block 2 children. Now see, an interesting story is coming here in block 3 children. Look here, the blue kite. What is the name of the story? Block 3, the blue kite children. Now see here, let us see some few keywords here. Goose, G-O-O-S-E, proud, P-R-O-U-D, jane, G-I-N-D, jane, wise, W-I-S-E, wise, admire, A-D-M-I-R-E, admire. These are the few keywords of today's lesson children. Now before starting lesson, let me tell you a small story now. Now see, Geeta is a girl. She eat her dinner at 9 and go to bed at 9:30. She wake up and do her brush. She go to school. She take a bath. What is this children? Is this in correct order? No. What you have to do? You should arrange, you should tell and you should arrange this in order. What is this order? In sequence. Don't tell it as order. You should tell it, arrange them in sequence. How? Geeta wake up early in the morning. She do her brush. She take her bath. She get ready to school. Next she eat her dinner at 9. She goes to her bed at 9:30. This is what a correct sequence. Now let me show you something. Now children see here. First. Then. Next. After that. Then and finally. This is sequence. According to this, you should tell. First, Geeta wakes up in the morning 7 o'clock. Then she brush her teeth and take her bath. Next, she gets ready to school. After that, she go to school. Then she comes home and eat her tiffin. Finally, she do her homework and she'll go to bed at 9:30. In this sequence, you should tell. Yes, children, now see, let me show you something. What you can see here, children? What is this all known as? What is this all? Kite. These all are different kites. You can see, no? A blue kite, a dragon kite. Next is kite. This is also a kite, children. Now, what we do? Now, see here. Today's lesson is the blue kite. Which one is the blue kite? She is blue kite. We are going to read a story on this blue kite. What is the name of this kite? Let us discuss afterwards. Then next, what kite you can see? A dragon kite. Where you can see this kite? Children, you can see this kite in India. And you can see this type of kite flying in China. So, these are different shapes and different size of kites.
Children, now see, turn to page number. See, what you can see here, children? Block 3, sequence, the blue kite. What you will study in this? We will study sequence of the events. Okay, next. Who wrote this story? Who is the author of this story? Kavita Sharma. She is author of this story. Author means she wrote the story, children. Now see what you can see here, children. Kites. What you can see here? Different size, shape and color. Kites. Next, see what you can see here. What is this, children? This is known as goose. No, a water bird. It is like duck. Yes. Now see. Keep your fingers where I am reading, children. One day, Zippy, the blue kite, flies high in the sky. Some bird fly past her. Zippy hears them talking. See, Zippy. What Zippy is doing? She's hearing what these birds are talking. Okay, next, turn to page number 24. See, Zippy and two birds here. Next, see, the kites in China have such bright colors. You can see them from far away, says a duck. What is telling? Duck is telling that, see, you can see that beautiful kites flying up. What, from where you can see? The kites are from China. And they have so many different shapes. Address a goose. Chinese kites are the best. Who is talking this? Goose is talking. Ducks are talking. The conversation is between duck, goose. Okay. Next, see here. Zippy looks at herself. She is just a blue square kite. The kites in China must be so much better than me, she thinks. I must see them. Who is telling this? Zippy is telling. For whom she is telling? She is thinking. By listening to this bird's conversation, talking, Zippy is thinking that, oh, they might be, Chinese kite might be so beautiful. Next. Then, the next morning, Zippy takes off for China. The wise old owl, see? Next day, Zippy, what Zippy is doing? She is telling that, I will go to China and see the different kites. Who is there here? Owl. What is the meaning of wise? You can see here the meanings. Glossary is nothing but meanings. Wise, knowledgeable. The wise old man told the king what to do. Next. Wise old owl, who sits in the pine tree, tells her the way. What this owl is telling? Telling where is China, from which way she can go. China is far, my dear. Fly east until you see the sea of grey whale, says the owl. What owl is telling? Fly to the eastern side till you see the sea of grey whale. Who is saying? Owl is telling. Next, see here. Zippy flies for many days and many nights. She flies over a tall mountain and thick forest. What Zippy is doing? Why she is going? She wants to see Chinese kite itself. So she is flying day and night. Next. Wow. See what you can see here? Wow. She is finally flying over a deep blue sea. She sees something huge and grey just blow with water. It is a grey whale. Zippy knows she is close to China. See, Zippy is smiling because she has seen this grey water whale. Next. See, children, turn to page number 27. See, she sees the Great Wall of China winding over mountain, winding over mountain and valleys. She sees Jane pandas climbing to bamboo tree. What do you mean? See, Jane pandas. What is the meaning of Jane? See, you can see here. Jane, very large. See, we got scared when the Jane wave crossed our boat. Jane means very big children. What Zippy is seeing here while flying? A giant big pandas. You know Kung Fu pandas? Pandas. See, they are climbing a bamboo tree. She is seeing this. Next. She is flying over China. Soon Zippy begins to see many colorful shapes in the sky. The kite in China really do looks amazing. Wow. At last, Zippy came to China. She is Zippy. What she's seeing? Wow! Different color, different shape, different size of kites. And see, dragon kite. What Zip is telling? Wow, really? Kites here are very different and amazing. Now see here. What you can see? You can see here two kites and Zippy. Total three kites. A huge yellow and red dragon kite flies towards Zippy. Behind her is a colorful butterfly kite. See butterfly kite? Kites of mine, different shapes and colors, are soon flying all around Zippy. But why are they all looking at her? You look so beautiful, blue kite, says the dragon kite. I wish I had a simple shade like you. You look so nice, says the butterfly kite. What is dragonfly and butterfly kite is telling to Zippy? You look so beautiful and simple. They are telling. Who is telling? Dragon kite and butterfly kite to Zippy. Now see. The other kites agree. They all admire Zippy. What is the meaning of admire? To look at something with respect. I admire all sports person. Next, see beta. The other kites agree. They all admire Zippy. The Zippy looks at herself. She is a lovely blue. Lovely blue. I like the deep blue. See. Here, square shape is simple, but it makes her look smart. And she is strong too. She can fly all the way to China. Zippy feels proud. What is the meaning of proud? Feeling happy. See, feeling happy because of something. Wants something one owns or has done. Zippy feels proud of herself. The kite in China are amazing. But she is amazing too. What they are telling? Wow, Zippy, you came to see Chinese kite from so long. And you are special. You are proud. We are proud to see you. They are telling that. Okay, so what is the story? Understood, children? What you can see here? See, children, today we have studied the sequence. See, you can see beautiful kite, blue kite, Zippy, no, white kite, yellow kite, and beautiful dragon kite. No, children, now kindly open your workbook, page number 21, S1, write today's date 18/8/2020. See here, sequence of events, answer the question for the story, the blue kite. They are asking some questions, beta. Be ready with your pencil to write. See, children. First one, answer the questions for the story, blue kite. I have read the blue kite story, children. Now see, where does Zippy decide to go? Zippy decide to go to China. First answer. Second one, what does Zippy see during the journey? Zippy sees tall mountain and thick forest. She sees the pandas climbing the tree and the blue sea, and she sees Great Wall of China. Next, third question. What does the dragon kite and the butterfly kite says about Zippy? Answer. The dragon kite and the butterfly kite says that Zippy looks so beautiful. Last, fourth one. How does Zippy feels in the end and why? In the end, Zippy feels proud of herself because everyone like her. Next one. Put the event in the correct order by numbering them. Read this all and put them in order. You should write here numbers better. Zippy feel proud of herself. Zippy hears them talking. Some birds fly past Zippy. She decided to go to China. Which will come first? You should write here better numbers. See better here. You should write like this. Numbers. This answer you should write with your own. List any two details from this story that are not important to the sequence of events. What is not important? You should write here, beta. Understood? Okay, kindly go through the video and complete your workbook. Thank you.